With the heavy snow that we just went through, one of the downsides is a snow mold that we get in our turf. Let's take a look. As I mentioned, there's two types of snow mold, pink and gray. They're both topical fungal infections. They don't cause any real long-term damage. You might notice your turf though comes out slower this spring. You want to wait till it gets a little bit dry before you start raking it up. This will be the stage that you notice right after the snow melts. As it dries, it'll actually disappear on its own. Take a stiff rake when you know that it is dry, and you can start kind of flaking away that webbing. The drying will basically make it disappear. Now, a couple of the things that make snow mold more prominent. If you go into the fall and your turf is too long, that's going to make it more of a problem. The other thing is avoid heavy nitrogen into the fall. And the other thing against us was the ground was not frozen, and then we had that heavy snow, so it was just ideal for the snow mold to flourish. Another really common problem under the snow is the damage that voles can do. You can see the tunneling, and they actually just eat the surface grass. So in one respect, it's a lot like the fungal problems. It's short term. My advice, rake it back and let those lower grass blades just come to naturally. If you decide to put soil and seed down, you might end up with a different texture that you're not going to be happy with. Appreciate you watching Plant Talk for our first one of the year, 2017. We'll see you again next time.